2016 is upon us. The wait is over. The offseason is done. We're in Vegas, Las Vegas, Nevada for the 2016 Gentlemen's Club Challenge at Wild Horse Golf Course. I am Jamie Thomas, the voice of SpinTV. Very happy to be back with you for year four. For those of you that have been with us since the beginning, we thank you so much. Over 31,000 people are subscribed to this channel at the time that we're making this video. Couldn't be more blessed and happy to be here with you guys talking some disc golf. We got a great final round. We got some bonus golf. Five competitors on the lead card. Leading the pack is Philo Brathwaite, the smooth control player out of Southern California. You guys know him and love him. We've got the gunslinger in Simon Lizotte, Matt Orum, Matt Bell, and Zackeriath Johnson. Two names, those last two names. You're gonna wanna know them if you don't already. Let's go. Hole one. Very reachable hole for these guys. Have to forgive the audio a little bit. Forgot to turn my mic on for the first hole, so the sweet sound of discs hitting the grass and the chains. Hold on, they're coming. Philo's going to leave his a little bit short. Matty O. Another big hyzer. They're both leaving it a little inside. And watch how that green slopes down to the left. Makes it a very difficult uphill run. Simon, the world's furthest thrower, unleashes one and makes the same mistake Matty O does, out to the left side. And that's going to be a tough two. And here's the guy you're going to want to get to know. Zach Johnson with a big booming forehand to start it. Great accuracy, and he's sitting right there putting for deuce. And Matt Bell making the adjustment, the correction, goes way right and sneaks back into frame. A little skip. Right there to start the round. And there's Matty O from down the hill. Not too much danger there. If you run too long, you can run into that cart path, but should be easy enough for these guys. Three guys wearing red, all off to the left side. Should be easy pitch. Take your three, move along. We are going five players on the lead card today, so we're going to skip a few of the tap-ins, a few of the easier things that you know they're kind of dropping in, so we can get to all the action in a timely manner. Matt Bell trying to capitalize, just misses it. And that's easy. Start with a birdie for Zach Johnson. Going to claim the box early on the Innova course here at the Wild Horse Golf Club. Could call it a golf complex with all the different courses going on. Hole one, not too much change, as you can see. Zach Johnson going to jump up one on Matt Bell, and everybody's within four. Hole two. Forgive the camera angle on this one a little bit. It's hard to see from the tee, so we're actually going to be off to the left side. Zach Johnson, big forehand spike again. Very reachable for all these guys. Here comes Philo, looking to not give up too many strokes to the field this early. Nice little low line, little skip shot. Feeds right there to the green. Very nicely done. Matty O. Making it look easy with these low line drives. You can see, obviously we're in Vegas, we're in the desert. You're gonna need a lot of skip. Can be very fast greens out here. Can run from you very quickly, but no problem. Simon looking like he went with his putter there. And Matt Bell out of Northern California, the guy who does all kinds of different things in the game well. I don't know if he has a signature thing that he does better than anybody else, but he's a complete golfer. He's got a lot of great shots in the bag. I've been able to see him in tournaments coming up in the region I play in. And Simon, easy deuce. This should be a pretty easy two for all these guys. Starting out two for two. Zach Johnson, very nicely done. And another easy little putt here. Very good. star frame. Everybody grabs one on hole two. This is going to be one of those courses where there's a lot of scoring opportunities, and you've got to get in where you fit in. You got to make sure that you're taking advantage of those opportunities, or they're going to get away from you really quickly. The weather out here was perfect. Not too hot. A little bit bright outside. Hard to track the disc with the camera sometimes, but Zach's going to challenge that water OB. Gets the green flag. You can see not too much skip on this green. It's a little thicker down there by the basket, so a little more confidence in the ability to grab and run. Ooh, speaking of a run, Philo trying to get a one on the card. Here's Matteo. A little short and inside with the hyzer. Did the same thing on hole one, but he should have a look at it. And Simon Lizotte going wide hyzer with the putter, trying to correct from what he did on one, and the bounce into the water. Yes, it'll be drop zone for Simon, and that's a long run from the drop zone over the corner of the lake. Matt Bell going a little bit higher on that spike. Left edge of the disc is down. He's a little long, but he gets the green flag. Simon from the drop zone to save his par. Gives it a good strong run. Shouldn't be too much of a problem for him to clean that up and get the three. Looks like the same is going to happen for Matt Bell. And Matteo to capitalize and get a stroke on Simon and get a little closer to Philo. Look how close he was. He's standing on the edge of the bank. But no problem for Zach Johnson. Matteo cleans up a par. And Philo playing the control game, what he's known for. He's managed these courses very, very well so far this weekend, really just making so few mistakes that guys, you have to shoot spectacularly to get in and take that from him. Par 3, 371 foot, hole 3. Another big forehand. And Zach's not very tall, but he's a great whip with his forehand when he just delivers it through the hit. Really fun to watch him throw. My first time seeing him throw, and just pretty cool customer for the most part on the course, and seemed to really enjoy being out there and competing. It's good to get to see him play. Philo gets hung up in the tree. Looks like he went a little bit long and hit the tree before it could hyzer. Yeah. Woo! Matteo likes it. Right in there on the green. Trying to get a two. A little closer to the leader. Another smooth line from Matt Bell. He'll have a downhill putt from that ridge. You can see his disc kind of hit right there. Simon going big. He may be deep. Looking like he is OB once again, two holes in a row. And you see the tree Philo hit. And it's a little layup. He doesn't need to worry too much. He does have an advantage. Matt Bell goes off the cage. He'd like to have that one back. Zach Johnson for birdie. Beautiful. Great velocity on the putt. Good height. Hits the chains. Sits right down. Tap the basket. Say thanks. And Simon for the par save. Getting the putter going. So important on a course like this where you're not going to have a whole lot of long holes. Everything is very reachable. The par fours and fives playing under for the most part in the top half of the field. You really have to, like we said before, you've got to score, make your holes count, because you're not going to be able to make a move on everybody. This is after four. Philo with a couple stroke lead still. And here's hole five, 454 feet. The green in front is OB. If you don't get it to the pin, 454 with the ceiling off the tee. but the slope runs quickly down to the cart path, which is also OB. And that, nice little bit of true love there. Zach Johnson, who has started out hot. Patio. And that's going to challenge that back line. He waits for the signal. Spectators say he's safe. Philo.
Come on. Okay, come on.
Asking for the disc. Get off the green, and he's pin high. Beautiful shot. Matt Bell going at the pin. Should have a look there for two. Here comes Simon. Two OBs in a row, trying to get a little something going here. And that looks deep again. He's on the backside of the slope. Out of bounds. Three holes in a row. Simon has now gone out of bounds off the tee, having a little trouble reining in that distance. And that time can't make the par save. Simon's over there saying, how's Matty-O in? And I'm out. So very close. You can see Matty-O gets a little unlucky there, rolls down all the way back to that brick wall. He's going to have a tough putt. Philo. Just to remind everybody who's in charge this round. Nice birdie. Matty O with a solid comeback. Under the tree, up the hill. Nicely done. And Simon dropping in his par putt, making it look easy. Matt Bell for a birdie. And Zach Johnson once again. He's now opened up with the first five, making a charge. And this is quickly becoming a duel between Zach Johnson and Philo Brathwaite. He's only two back at this point, and he's jumped all of the other competitors on the card. Matty-O's three back. Let's go to hole six. 251 feet, you're throwing over the corner of the water to one of the teeing areas for the golf course. Not a huge green. Zach gets a green flag. Philo to respond. Plays a little bit safer. He's gonna make sure it's inside.
Thank you.
Right there. Philo was nervous about that one for a second, but clean all the way. Beautiful putter shot. Here's Matt Bell. A little long, waiting for the signal. Opportunity for birdie coming up. Matty-O. Ooh, that may be trouble.
No.
And gonna get the red flag rolled into the back. Rolled off the back screen, I should say.
Oh,
Simon just wings one out there.
Coming.
Way right. He's going to need a miracle.
Splash. God, ass.
You can hear him frustrated with himself at this point. Hadn't been able to dial in the accuracy. He's got plenty of power. I don't know if it's possible, but he's looking even stronger and throwing even further than he was last year when he smashed the distance record. Having a little trouble on the putting green today and a little bit of the accuracy, but the power is definitely there, folks. So throughout the year, we should see some great stuff from him. And that'll be a four for Simon. Four for Matt Orum. Philo just making it look easy so far. Water, OB, uphill, downhill so far hasn't really mattered. Just dueling in the desert with this man right here. Zach Johnson. Right in the heart. Beautifully done. Let's go to hole seven. Again, Zach Johnson, two strokes back. Matt Bell, Matt Orum, tied at five back. Simon's struggling a little bit. Here's hole seven. See all the red lines on the map here? That's out of bounds. The green's OB. The the bunkers are going to play like a bunker rule in disc golf, where you kind of like the hazards at USDGC, where you're going to play from inside of them with a one-stroke penalty, which can make it a little difficult on that footing if you want to take a jump putt or something like that. And Zach Johnson's going to test that. And that was a big, he shows he's got the backhand and the forehand because he's pin high on this hole. That was a massive rip. Saying, Simon, you're not the only one with power.
There you go.
Nice.
There you go.
There you go. Who needs power when you got control? Got Bell throwing a little low line drive. Needing a skip. And he gets a big skip. He may be in the trees to the left of the fairway there. He will most likely be inbounds, but the footing and the basket may be obscured from his lie coming up. Matteo getting a little more height on the shot, getting past the trees. And this one looked like it slipped out of Simon's hand. That's early. And he catches those trees, and he might have been lucky there because he may have been way left of that basket. That's Matt Bell out from the covered position, just going to pitch up, take the three. Simon going to give it a run. Nestles safely there. Three for him. This would be a big moment to capitalize for Philo. Ooh, just leaves it short. The opportunity to get one, maybe two strokes from Zach right here, who is in the bunker. Not afraid, gonna run it. Gives it a good run, but he'll take a four if he can clean that putt up there. And closest to the pin, Matt Orum. Should be easy, so that'll be threes for all the guys, a four for Zach Johnson with the penalty. Got two more holes to play in this front nine. Made a real strong move those first six holes where Zach Johnson opened up six for six, but fell back a little bit while Philo's still sitting comfortably in the lead. Hole 8, 403 feet. It's hard to see in the camera where the pin is from this tee. Look for the little flag stick. Most of these guys are throwing, you know, putters or mids down there. It can, you can get long of the basket very quickly. It drops off. And obviously the skip factor, as we said, we are playing in the desert. And even though they're keeping green grass growing out here, it's could still be fast. Matteo, that one looks nice. Just needs a little bit of skip. And the crowd appreciates that. Here's Simon. Pretty shot, needs to get a little bit more left. And here comes the kid. That's a big time overhand shot. And Simon looked at me and kind of looked at me and shook his head as we were walking up to these next lies. He's been impressed with the gunslinging of Zach Johnson so far this round, and he's been throwing some impressive shots. Forehand, backhand, overhand, seems to have it all. Welcome to the scene. Matt Bell just a little high on his birdie attempt. Here's Philo in a big moment. Take one back to go four up on the field. Big putt from Philo. Looking very confident. And Simon zips it right in there. Clean up pars. Zach Johnson and Patio. Park job. Nicely done. Go on to, we're already at hole nine, guys. This has been a great round so far. Just watching all the swings. Did not expect to see it turn out like this, but still got 10 to go. 10 to play. Hole nine, par four, 633 feet. Very reachable for all these guys. They should be getting threes on this. Basket's a little bit to the left. It's a slight dog leg left for those righty backhand hyzers. All you really have to do is just get it out in the fairway. Just get it past these trees. Be sitting nice and pretty out there in the grass. And make your upshot count. There's a bunker right by the basket. You don't want to take that extra stroke just due to some accuracy errors. And Simon, always the entertainer. Look between the trees as we zoom in. You'll see the disc sneak through. And that's huge, but he looks to be out of bounds right. The disc just didn't quite hook back up from him, but he's way up the fairway. Easy hyzers. Everybody else. Not a whole lot of trouble you can get into off the tee unless you hit those first trees. So essentially all these guys are just playing the spot and making sure the upshot counts. Just like that. Beautifully done. Philo gonna line up beforehand. He's gonna play the skip factor. Play these fast greens. Sitting right on the backside. Maybe a little bit of a death putt. Yeah. Can't airball from where he is or risk going into the bunker. Zach, though, on that smoky gray disc that's so hard to follow with a camera. You have to get him a brighter color disc if he's gonna be on tour. And Matty O. Nicely done. Here's Simon. He was out. That's how far up the fairway he was. Legendary Dave Dunapace standing behind him watching him. And he had a jump putter to the par four. And spoiler alert, folks, this won't be the last time. You're going to see in the back nine coming up, the distance shows. And that's a great par save. He will take his four. Matt Bell with a three. And when the basket is sitting on the peak of the hill like that, this is where the pros and the ams can get separated here. You've got to know that you're going to put it right in the heart of the chains. Any, you know, action out of the sides of the basket or cutting through or anything like that, if you're not right on target, you're going to give that disc some energy when it hits the ground, and you may be further away for your second putt than you were for your first. No problem here. And everybody will three this hole with the exception of Simon, taking a four with the penalty stroke. We're already through nine holes. Nine down, nine to go at the Wild Horse Golf Course in Las Vegas, Nevada. Philo Brathwaite up to a four-stroke lead over Zach Johnson. Matt Orum and Bell right behind him. Simon slipped a little bit. We'll look to see good things from him in the back nine. And it's been a duel so far. Two names rose to the front of the pack, and they're going to aim for the prize. Drive for show, putt for dough. Here in Vegas. I'm Jamie Thomas. This is SpinTV. See you next time.